In this tutorial, we will try to explain step by step the text tools in MS Paint and all its features. To get the most out of this training, following this content and our previous and subsequent or other related trainings that we publish in series will help you understand and achieve much more. We open MS Paint and start with a clean and blank canvas with a white background color. By selecting the letter A, which symbolizes the text tool in the tools section, we can write the text we want anywhere on the canvas. With the text tool selected, we use the left mouse button to select the area on the canvas where we will enter the text. When the area to write text on the canvas becomes active, the text tools tab automatically appears above. In the text tools tab, we can specify many properties of typefaces, such as size, font, boldness, italics, underline, and background. Although the ready-made text fonts are given values between 8 and 72, we can change the font size values by typing the numbers we want from the keyboard. If the font size value we enter is larger than the text field we set, it is possible to expand and adjust the text field later. Here, let's quickly show some basic typing tool features on a letter T. As you can see, apart from bold, italic, underline, and center line, we can change the font as we like. We can change the background color of our text to any color, opaque or transparent. We can choose the colors of all or each of our typefaces individually as we wish. Here we have prepared a text example with many different colors to serve as an example. Unlike all these, the eraser tool has the ability to change the color of the text, so we can design our text color in many different ways. In our previous lessons, we talked about the ability to change color in the eraser tool. For a better understanding, we recommend that you review our lessons on eraser. Thanks to the color changing feature of the eraser tool, it is possible to create designs with unlimited color painting and color variations even from a single typeface. We use the selection method to rotate and orient the text we write. In our tutorial on selection tools, we talked in more detail about how to rotate selected image objects or text, and we recommend that you watch the previous tutorial if you haven't already. After selecting the rotation operations with the selection tool, we can achieve the rotation effect by tilting the selected area vertically and horizontally under the basic rotation commands or indirectly under the resize menu. We can select the texts we have created and use other manipulation tools to make some changes to them or delete them completely. The 3D lettering effect is a feature we have already discussed in detail in the brushes and shapes tutorial. To give the 3D effect, it is important that the selected text or object or character is a transparent selection. We can create a 3D or relief effect by first holding down the Shift key on the keyboard and then moving the transparently selected text with mouse movements or with the arrow direction keys on the keyboard. Another important text effect is to completely cover our text with a pattern. To do this, we can import an external image file onto our canvas, which we will use as an overlay. Our first step is to import an external image file. We also recommend the previous tutorials, where we went into detail about importing an external image file. Previous content always contributes to a better understanding of the topic. From the outside, we place a wallpaper with the theme of green dense-leaved forest plants on our canvas and resize it. This time, we want to show it with a larger text, so we expand our canvas area with the mouse to provide a little more working space. We will then bring the canvas area back to its original size. On a blank part of the canvas, We wrote a text of our choice in one color and black, either by writing it or taking it from somewhere. We set the second color, our background color, to black, and then enabled a transparent selection feature from the selection tools. With the transparent selection feature active, we select our text from the image file we imported from outside and align it as we want. Since the text part of our selection is transparent, the outer white area of the selection acts as a kind of mask so that our text automatically appears to be colored with the color of the area below it. Once our alignment is complete, we click on an empty space on the canvas to create our textured pattern text, deleting and removing unwanted or excess pieces. We design a similar example in a different writing style by transferring a different image file for better understanding in an accelerated way. As we mentioned earlier, the manipulation techniques that we can apply on canvas with selection tools and other tools and commands can also be used on text, including inverting colors. In line with what we have explained so far, we create a composition within the framework of the commands and operations we have shown quickly. And thanks to this quick explanation, the understanding of the subject will be further strengthened and facilitated. Yes, we have come to the end of this training content. If you haven't seen it, we recommend you to watch the previous and subsequent trainings of the series. We will continue the series with more beautiful trainings, and we will be with you again very soon. Don't forget to subscribe and click the bell to receive notifications for new videos. See you again soon, and thanks for watching.